Hi everyone, I hope you're doing really well. I realize it's been a while since I've posted something, but I'm back and I have some favorites from last month I wanted to share. So I'm going to jump into that and just say hello. So I'm going to start with last month. I think I probably used these two eye palettes the most of anything in my collection. And one is the Rihanna MAC palette. It's called Smoked Cocoa. And you can still get this at CCOs and I think some MAC counters, and it's just really, really fantastic. It's got a nice cool taupe, a good highlight color, and two different types of blacks. And I just think this is easy. I like the taupe on the lids and the sparkling black in the crease. And that sounds a little crazy, but it really does work well, and it's really a huge favorite of mine, even though I'm not a big MAC shadow person. I just like that combination so much. And then I've been loving the Naked Basics palette. I know this is old, we all have it, we probably don't use it very often, but I used it today, and I think you can get a pretty decent smoky eye out of it, but you can also do something really, really neutral. Sometimes I use Naked 2 in the crease and Walk of Shame on the lids, and they all look very similar in the pan, but on the eyes, it's really pretty. So I really like this. My favorite mascara this month is probably not a shocker. I've gone back to Voluminous Original. This just happened to be some sort of commemorative tube, but I really love this one. And I get such good results, and it washes off really easily, so that's a favorite. What else have I pulled out? Oh my gosh, love this. I'm super excited about this. I bought a new eye cream during I want to say it was the VIB sale, but it's been a while, so it might have been. It's the Caudalie Polyphenol Anti-Wrinkle Eye and Lip Cream. I love that it comes in this packaging. This is 0.5 ounce, so it's half an ounce, and it's just really convenient, but it's so soothing. It's so soothing. Sometimes for me, eye creams can bother my eyes, like literally my eyes, not even just the skin, that too, but the eyes. And this is just extremely soothing, and I really, really love it. So the other things, let's see, what else was I going to tell you about? I feel like I have a bunch of new things I haven't really shown you or discussed, but it's not jumping out at me. Anyway, here's another one. This is the Guerlain Terracotta Jolie Tint. This is a sunscreen slash foundation, and it comes in a pump. It's really, really nice. It's kind of expensive. It was like $58, which is kind of nuts for a foundation. But I'm wearing it today, and what it does is it kind of brings a glow to the skin. Not glow as in shine, which I hate, but it sort of makes your skin look healthier. Maybe it has a tad of self-tanner, something. It does something, and it doesn't really explain on the packaging what it does, but I really like how it looks. And it's a pretty sheer foundation. I'm also totally in love with the Perfection foundation from Guerlain, so I've kind of become a little bit of a Guerlain nut. Love these both. And then I have two glosses out, and I've been absolutely in love with this. This is a bronzer from Givenchy. Looks like that. The packaging is amazing, the way they made it so pretty. This is a Real Techniques, I think they called it the blush brush. And I just use this sort of like a bronzer because I am pale. Some people may be able to use this as a highlighter, not me. Okay, I say I'm pale, but look how burnt I am. I took the kids to the pool today. Not good. It's gonna hurt. In fact, it already does. Yay. Sunscreen. I have a sunscreen that, forgive me, I swear by, and I probably should have used more this morning. It is the Sunbum SPF 50. Sometimes I get this on sale, buy one, get one half off at Ulta, and I really like this. I have asthma, so a lot of spray sunscreens affect my breathing. This one, it doesn't, and it works really, really well. It also doesn't have any parabens, and it has all kinds of promises in the back, but it's a great brand, great product. I really, really like it. So anyway, lastly, the last two things I was going to show you that I use all the time now, not today, of course. The Laura Mercier gloss in Bare Naked is just a really nice nude. If you saw my Pin Me Up session that I posted on Instagram and on Facebook, I was wearing this. And then the other one I love, love, love is the Cupcake Gloss from NYX. This is one of their butter glosses. This is so pretty. I'll swatch it. It's just a really nice, bright, warm pink. So anyway, I hope you're having a great weekend. Happy 4th of July. And I will talk to you soon. I'm going to be doing empties. And then after that, if you have any requests, let me know. Take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.